It was a damaging revelation delivered in a very public way, a front-page Boston Globe report that Mayor Marty Walsh is caught up in a federal investigation of organized labor in the Boston area. The report sent the rest of the media into overdrive, but the mayor says he's not getting a fair shake. Adam has more.
The Boston Globe says Mayor Marty Walsh is ensnared in a federal investigation into strong-arm union tactics. Allegedly, he was caught on a wiretap in 2012 saying he'd pushed a developer to use union labor. That was before Walsh became mayor, but the revelation was still big news.
A federal investigation into unions.
At the time, Walsh was the head of the Boston Building Trades.
I think you could be indicted?
Absolutely not.
In a follow-up editorial, the Globe urged Walsh to just answer whether he's appeared before a grand jury or received a subpoena. Walsh pushed back hard in a sympathetic interview on Boston Herald Radio, where he had harsh words for the Globe's coverage.
Attacking somebody's integrity, I think, is unfortunate. And unfortunately, I guess I don't know if that sells papers. There's no factual evidence that it's all people off the record.
Of course, off the record tips can also be factual. Now that he's played media critic, the mayor seems eager to move on.
I'm not going to play this out in the press. If there's issues here, it's a legal issue. We'll let the United States Attorney's Office handle it.
But unless Walsh says flat out that he hasn't appeared before a grand jury, the press will keep hacking away.
So, Adam, as you know, because you did it, we reached out to Boston Globe editor Brian McGrory, who got back to us with a very thoughtful statement, first saying he realizes the mayor is at a disadvantage because it was an anonymous source. But then he went on to say that in this case, though, the sources more than met our rigorous standards, and the information that a mayor has been drawn into a federal investigation raises compelling questions that we believe the public is best served to know about. And, you know, he went on to say that it's incumbent on them to really look at this and treat the mayor as fairly as possible as the investigation goes forward.
It struck me as a statement that indicated he's very genuinely sympathetic to, maybe sympathetic is the wrong word, attuned to the concerns that the mayor might have. This is such a complex story that I don't want to get us too down in the legal weeds, but one thing that I think is worth pointing out is we don't know what kind of constraints Marty Walsh is operating under. That Globe editorial that was, I think, written by Katie Kingsbury, that made it sound like it's no big deal. You can just say whether you appear before a grand jury or not. Then there was a follow-up piece that ran in the Globe, co-authored by Nancy Gertner, which said, actually, everyone gets a letter saying don't say
federal
if
judge,
you've been subpoenaed to appear before a federal grand jury. I've done a little reporting on this, and my understanding is that neither one is quite right, that on occasion people are told, we would like you to not talk about what you've been through appearing before a grand jury, and on occasion they're not. Now, we don't even know if Marty Walsh has or has not appeared before one, and if he did, by the way, that is no indication that he's accused of any wrongdoing. I'll shut myself up there, but
The tone of the reporting suggests that Marty Walsh is being asked in connection with investigations into other people. Mm-hmm. And, you know, certainly if the U.S. Attorney's Office is going to leak, then the media is going to pick up on those leaks. And the U.S. Attorney's Office in this city, and I imagine in cities around the country, loves to leak. This is how they seem to go about conducting some of their investigations.
But what advantage?
You get this information out there and you flush out people who may have information. They'll come forward and it advances your investigation. It's really kind of a lousy game. I have no problem with the way the Globe has reported this, but at the same time, I would love to see the Globe or somebody or another news organization just kind of step back and take a harder look at this investigation by leak technique that the U.S. Attorney's Office.
I got to hop in.
We're assuming it's the U.S. Attorney's Office.
We don't know.
Well, assuming.
Okay, and I don't think
he said that too.
No,
the mayor has suggested otherwise.
Good point. We don't know, but we're assuming.
And Dan said assuming.
And even, by the way, Brian McGrory said, you know, that the sources meet our rigorous standards. It's not some fly by night, you know.
I just want to say this, that, you know, when you have such a story like this, that the weight of it is that it follows you.
Yeah.
And so that's where Mayor Walsh is. And honestly, I understand where Brian McGorry is, too. They want to be very careful about this because it just sticks to you.
Oh, yeah.
And then you spend the whole time saying, no, I didn't, no, I didn't, no, I didn't. I mean, and there you are.
Well, it's a worst of both worlds situation for him, because there's no indication that there's anyone looking into anything, you know, in this case that he did while in office, the case about the building trades. Yeah. This is something that happened, in 2014, probably before he even thought about running for mayor. The problem for him politically is that it feeds into this narrative that everyone had when he was running. Everyone was worried, is he going to be, he's the head of the building trades, is he going to be in the back pocket of the union? So it's a political problem for him, and that's the thing that lingers, whether there's a legal problem or not.
It's worth pointing out, too, I think, that what he is, what he allegedly was picked up on a wiretap saying, I think is sort of not eyebrow-raising stuff. It wasn't some sort of profanity-laced tirade in which he threatened to, have tires slashed or something like that. He was speaking with a union official saying, I mentioned to a developer they might have trouble getting zoning for a project in Boston if they didn't use union labor at a project in Somerville. And he was the head of the Boston building trades. So I personally would expect him to say that sort of thing.
Well,
that being said, if I were in the Globe shoes and I learned that he'd been picked up on a wiretap having a conversation.
Well, we don't have a quote from the wiretap, so we don't really know.
No, we don't.
You don't have the context,
you don't have the tone.
Right.
You don't know. The other person can say,
That's true.
It's coming from you, so that means something else.
And there's a fine line between strong persuasion and a perceived threat.
Yeah.
That's exactly right.
Because one is illegal and the other isn't.
Well, that's right. And therein lies the whole discussion here.